Well, basically, is if you leave the crane at the front of the tractor, it's front heavy, and the back wheels start to come off the ground, and so then you can't, that then it won't grip. So what you do, you turn the crane right round the back, and that puts the weight to the back of the tractor. And as you're going along, if one wheel starts to slip slightly, well, just turn the crane that way, gives it a bit more grip, you see. And so then the other lot might slip a bit. Well, just turn the crane the other way, you see. So it's a bit more, a bit like a tail on a monkey, really. It does a bit of a balancing act, really.
Welcome to 21st Century Forestry. That was Richard Palmer talking about negotiating difficult terrain with heavy machinery. Richard has cut off the peripheral branches to allow easy access to the bottom of the trunk. Here, Richard is cutting a wedge into the base of the trunk to allow him to safely direct the fall of the tree into his chosen direction. Richard then uses his tractor crane to gather the trunks and branches. But what if the terrain won't support the heavy vehicle? Well, then he has to use the skyline. The skyline consists of the tower and a trolley that runs along a steel cable. A chain is wrapped around the tree trunk. And then pulled towards the trolley. When in position, the trolley travels back towards the tower. This system is controlled by a winch at the base of the tower. Unfortunately, heavy rain causes the winch to catch and jump, requiring operations to cease. Once all of the branches and trunks are in a pile accessible by the tractor, they are chained together and winched to the back of the tractor. Richard then returns to the yard to process the wood. Once back at the yard, the logs are loaded into a machine which saws and splits the wood into manageable pieces, which can then be sold as firewood.